Only the reason, cyanide is strong field ligand and fluoride is weak field ligand. In such case, delta 0 is less than P. When the energy difference between these two is less, in such cases, dxy, dyz, dzx. Similarly, dx square, y square, dz square. So, the two orbitals are present here. Now, come to this. First electron enters here, second electron enters here, third electron enters here. Now, the fourth electron enters into EG level because of delta 0 value less than P. Means, the amount of energy required for pairing is more than the electron wants to jump into EG energy level. So, fifth electron, now the sixth electron. Come to this, is there any vacant d orbitals available in cobalt plus 3 metal ion? Is there is no vacant d orbital. So, in such cases, the ligands have to or to bind with 6 ligands, the cobalt have to facilitate the d orbital which is present in outer orbit. So, in such cases, they produce outer orbital complexes. In this case, due to empty vacant orbitals, empty d orbitals, it produces inner orbital complexes. All it depends upon strength of the ligand. In the presence of strong field ligands, pairing of electrons takes place and provides inner orbital complexes. In the presence of weak field ligand, pairing of electron not takes place and produces stronger field or outer orbital complexes with paramagnetic character. So, this is about formation of these. And second one, let us explain splitting of d orbitals in splitting of d orbitals in square planar geometry. Splitting of d orbitals in square planar or tetrahedral geometry. Let us consider the same explanations, the detailed explanation we give in case of octahedral complexes, but in tetrahedral complexes, when 4 ligands are approaching near to the metal ion of the given coordination sphere, okay, 4 ligands, in such case, again, the 5 orbitals present at metal atom, while we are going to add this, all the 5 ligands enters into high energetic level, it is called as degeneracy state. So, remember, at degeneracy state, all the 5 d orbitals with same amount of energy, that is dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square, y square, dz square orbitals having similar amount of energy. But when they are going to interact with orbitals, it will be happen like this. In such case, especially in tetrahedral geometry, dx square, y square and dz square orbital face less repulsion with ligand, hence enters into less energetic EG level, or we can consider it is E level, where due to more repulsion between dxy, dyz, dzx orbital, they enters into high energetic level, that is T2 level. Now, the energy difference between E and T2 will be represented as delta T. So, what is delta T here? Energy difference between two energy levels in tetrahedral geometry. In the same explanation, in case of strong field ligands, the energy difference is more. In such case, most of the electron wants to get dx square, y square, dz square, and pairing takes place, and which can offer vacant d orbital to produce inner orbital complexes. But in case of weak field ligand, as the energy gap is less, okay, energy gap is less, it is 2 by 5 and it is 3 by 5. So 2 by 5 delta and 3 by 5 delta. Here, due to energy difference between the 2E and T2 levels is less, in case of weak field ligands, the electrons may occupy dx square y square dz square, at the same time may enters into dxy dyz dzx and cannot offer empty d orbitals to make coordination covalent bond with the ligands. So in such case, it can offer outer orbital metal complexes. So this is valency bond theory. So this valency bond theory will help us to explain color of coordination complexes. It is useful to explain color of coordination complexes. So remember, crystal field theory is an electrostatic. It depends upon electrostatic theory, or it explains based on electrostatic forces. In simple language, in the presence of ligand, based on the strength of the ligand, in octahedral and tetrahedral complexes, for the 5d orbitals split into two energy levels. The energy difference between these two energy levels depends upon the strength of the ligand. So the most important spectrochemical series is the most important to identify in which condition the given metal complex show outer orbital complexes, in which condition the metal complex will show inner orbital complexes. This is about crystal field theory.